Hello friends, welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today, and we're going to share three latest and significant SpaceX updates with you. We'll commence with third static fire of Ship 20, side-by-side upcoming launch of Starlink, we'll also discuss on the successful Crew 3 mission, then we'll discuss the second generation design of Starlink's satellite dishes. Lastly, we'll discuss how the International Space Station dodged space junk. Before we dig into the details, we're excited to let you know that we've launched our new channel, Defense Today, to cater your latest updates about U.S. defense programs and some global movements as well. Check the link description below to give it a look and please subscribe. Let's begin with the successful launch of the Crew 3 mission, Ship 20 Static Fire, and Starlink 4-1 launch. After facing a series of delays due to weather and others, SpaceX has finally launched their Crew 3 mission to the International Space Station. On the 10th of November, Wednesday, at 9:03 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, SpaceX teams carried out the mission aboard C-210 Endurance Crew Dragon capsule atop their once-flown booster, B-1067. This launch was carried out just 2 days after Crew 2's return. NASA Commercial Crew tweeted on the 11th of November, "Four astronauts are now on their way to the space station aboard SpaceX's Crew Dragon Endurance spacecraft. Recent updates states that Starlink 4-1 launch has been scrubbed by SpaceX due to poor weather. Now they've another launch window on the 13th of November. On the other hand, the Starship SN20 vehicle ignited all six of its Raptor engines in a brief static fire test on November 12th at Starbase, SpaceX's facility near the South Texas village of Boca Chica. SpaceX founder and CEO Elon Musk tweeted shortly after the test, "Good static fire with all six engines." This wasn't the first static fire for SN20. Previously, SpaceX performed back-to-back static fires with the same vehicle on October 22nd, but SN20 had just two Raptors installed at that time. This test involved the flight configuration of six engines, three standard sea-level Raptors, and three optimized to perform in the vacuum of space. Though the timing of that liftoff is unclear, partly because the U.S. Federal Aviation Administration is still conducting an environmental assessment of the Starbase orbital launch site, the FAA has filed a draft assessment and collected public comments on the document, but the final report has not yet been released. Now let's take a look at Crew 3, which marked the 24th launch of the year for SpaceX. This mission also commences the fifth crewed launch of SpaceX since their first crewed test flight, named Demo 2, in May 2020. As we can see, SpaceX has carried out all five successful crewed launches, Demo 2, Crew 1, Crew 2, Inspiration 4, and recently Crew 3, in less than a year and a half. In the fastest five-flight milestone, SpaceX's Crew Dragon spacecraft comes in the middle of the list. It's worth noting that all the other spacecrafts which have placed themselves either above or beyond Dragon are from government-run space agencies who have much larger budget power than a private space company. SpaceX, being a private space company, has managed to reach a good position in the fastest five-flight milestone, which is quite a decent achievement for them. This time, the crew rotation procedure in the International Space Station was a bit disturbed. It was planned that Crew 3 astronauts will arrive at the station prior to Crew 2's return, which will help in crew rotation procedure with zero interruption. But due to weather issues, Crew 3 launch was delayed, which made NASA return their Crew 2 astronauts first, leaving the space station in the hands of a minimal crew for almost 3 days. As for now, with the Crew 3 launched, the crew capsule will now dock with the ISS, letting the four astronauts to join other astronauts in the space station. Along with the four astronauts, Crew 3 has sent numerous experiments to the space station. According to some reports, during the six-month stay of four Crew 3 astronauts, Raja Chari, Thomas Marshburn, Kayla Barron and Matthias Maurer at the space station. All the astronauts will carry out about 200 research investigations on separate grounds. Report says that the crew will work on hundreds of experiments, which will include research for new medical technologies. With this research, scientists will be able to heal diseases further. The data obtained from this research will further help the space agencies in finding out the effect of space on the human body. This will make them able to train astronauts for interplanetary transport to Mars and beyond. A protein crystal growth experiment from the National Cancer Institute has been sent to the station. Under this uniform protein crystal growth experiment, small crystals of RNA will be grown in microgravity, and then it will be observed using a powerful light source to look at their three-dimensional shape. Researchers will grow a bunch of RNA crystals in space and send them back to Earth, where researchers will analyze their 3D atomic structure. This investigation also focuses on X-ray-free electron laser technology, which enables imaging of biological molecules. Report says researchers will also focus on riboswitch RNA as it controls gene expression. The crew will investigate the effect of an enhanced spaceflight diet on astronaut health as part of a food physiology experiment. Let's move to our next update about the new design of Starlink satellite internet dish. SpaceX announced its new Starlink satellite internet dish on its Starlink support page. This new dish is square designed and is more compact, lighter, and smaller than the older circular dish. It weighs just 9.2 pounds. SpaceX also received approval from the Federal Communications Commission for using the new dishes. The company was planning to launch the newly designed dish from several months in order to reduce production costs and enhance the output. SpaceX CFO Brett Johnson said during the annual satellite conference in September that every week around 5,000 Starlink dishes were being manufactured by the company. He provided information about designs of the new satellite and also mentioned that the design would reduce cost to a large extent. The dish consists of a 3x3 MU-MIMO router. This will help in transmitting three bandwidth streams to three devices. Thus, issues related to slowing down of network, which are usually faced with single modem devices, will be effectively minimized. The previous model, however, had a 2x2 MU-MIMO router. The modem's ability to withstand different weather conditions has also improved. The new device can operate under lower temperatures like negative 30 degrees Celsius and higher temperatures like 50 degrees Celsius. It's also waterproof like the first device. Even after having so many additional features, the price of the dish will remain the same at $499. The company's support page said, "Bypass functionality is coming soon, and we're actively working on development of a Starlink mesh product." There is, however, no built-in Ethernet port in the new dish. This is the only drawback of the second-generation dishes. A separate Ethernet adapter will be sold along with the newly designed dishes in SpaceX's online shop. Now, today's final update on how the International Space Station dodged a Chinese space junk. Just hours before the launch of Crew 3, the International Space Station had to dodge a piece of Chinese space junk on November 10th. NASA's International Space Station Program Manager Joe Montalbano told the reporters on the 9th of November, "The space station team is tracking a piece of debris and are planning a debris avoidance maneuver about 6 hours prior to launch." According to Roscosmos, the activity was scheduled to start at 3:15 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Fire thrusters were planned to operate for 31 seconds to clear the junk. The junk is named 35114, according to NASA's catalog of space objects. It's also identified as a piece of debris from a Chinese anti-satellite weapons test in 2007. The debris was actually part of a Chinese weather satellite. It resulted from a missile test performed from China. According to an astronomer at Harvard, Jonathan McDowell, who tracks objects in space, the destruction of the satellite in orbit produced 3,537 debris pieces. He also said the two objects' closest approach is estimated to occur on November 12th. Montalbano said, "We did have a reboost planned for November 16th, and this maneuver will go ahead and take care of that." That's all for today, And, oh yes, please don't forget to visit our new channel, Defense Today. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.